fair few birds you've hunted. I wonder if it might be worth visiting the Raven Tree.
Siphon away the light of that ibex.
We will stop it.
We can't kill it. We'll have to burn it out. Good. You scared it back to its spring. We were just in time. The Ibex would not survive much longer. But there may be more creatures in danger. We should look for other wisps. Look, that spring's glowing. There's something angry inside of it. There's a metal plate here with glowing runes. Connected to the wisps, maybe? A gazelle. It's being preyed upon by another of the wisps. It'll live. I see. The plate keeps the wisps locked in their springs. It's a trap.
Ah, another crystal. Best hold on to it until we can figure out what to do with it.
I could have seen this place before the boom.
More say that.
Free from their suffering.
Good thing you learned the runes, brother. I believe that's the last of them.
And that's the last of them. Spectacular work, I guess. Not that I care. You mean nothing to me. Nothing at all.
That's great, friend.
You're not my friend. Bye. I love you.
Good gracious.
But, could be pointier. Now go skewer some folk. Always a pleasure.
Careful, brother. You're covered in Bifrost.
Good riddance!
Trap the wisps.
Wisps tend to combine. The imprisonment plate is likely meant to prevent that. Another wisp. It's killing the wisps. Was too far gone. At least the wisps are contained. We should
about that.
They found a way to combine. We must destroy it for good.
Alpha.
Gave yourself an opening. Don't waste it. Need to take out those spikes, brother!
That's it!
Go!
handled the Wisp problem. I'd like to know how they managed to escape and form that creature, though.
Chains only hold for so long. Eventually, those who wear them will break free, one way or another.
You can say that again, brother.
Through them, then a spear. Y'all come back now.
Progress finding lean work.
I have retrieved
you. No more now.
Here.
Time. Show the boss what you got.
Wise beyond its years, this one. All of the little ones are now safely settled in their new home. You have my gratitude.
Might have done it sooner.
You sought the dragon's offspring. Why?
Ah, to alleviate my heart-rending loneliness, of course.
Oh, that was awfully forthcoming of you.
I normally wouldn't be so candid, but it appears that Anxious Squirrel has learned a thing or two from you about, what was it? Not caring about how others perceive you? So I will permit you this one glimpse of my weakness.
To require others is not a weakness.
My goodness. I had not expected such emotional intelligence from one of your girth.
I do not care.
Oh, well, this was a delightful conversation. Now, what else might there be to discuss?
Something I've been meaning to ask. Once you projected an emotional trait into spectral form, is it just gone from you? Suppose a friend wished to cast off his melancholy, or a predilection towards pining.
I see. But I'm afraid it's not so simple. My spectral projections give me a measure of emotional breathing room, but it is only temporary. If I fail to reassimilate them, they start to fester.
Fester?
They are concentrated beings of emotion, and if left alone for too long, that emotion feeds on itself and becomes more and more, pronounced. Which is why I must periodically reabsorb them, deal with their emotional baggage internally, and then eject them fully recharged.
Huh. Absorbing all that emotion at once must be pretty bitter medicine to swallow.
Oh, yes, it's quite unpleasant. Terrible, in fact. Do not recommend. Well, best of luck to your friend, good Master Amir.